Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. If you don't know me, my name is Katie and I make stuff vegan. Okay, so boom. Y'all, I don't even know how this recipe came about or like my inspiration because of course, like always, I was gonna do something completely different. I think it's because I recently followed the Snack Queen on TikTok. Like she is so cute, she has such good energy and she lives in California. So I think she probably went to In-N-Out and I was like, I should make some In-N-Out. Have I made? And I was like, I've never made animal fries. Now I have not had In-N-Out ever because I've been to California probably like 5 times and the last 4 times were LA and I was vegan by then, so you know, oh well. But I did have like a style of it because there's this restaurant called Doomies. There's one in LA, there's one in Toronto. I've been to both and they have an animal fry, so I have like the gist of it, so I kind of knew what I was doing. So if you want to see how I made animal fries, if you want to see how I made vegan animal fries from In-N-Out, you know what I'm saying? Keep on watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to never miss any of my videos. And as always, the link to the detailed recipe will be in the description box below. Okay, let's get started. Okay, so if you don't know what animal fries are, they're basically a cheese fry with Thousand Island dressing. It's not really Thousand Island, but like basically with Thousand Island dressing and grilled onions. So like, it's probably like a cheat day meal, or if you're living your life into the day-to-day season, yeah, some of all I did was rest, okay, sorry. I love Drake. I love Drake so much. The heart is questionable in the head, but you know, I love that it makes him happy. Anyway, we are way off topic. That's what animal fries are. I've seen people like put cheese slices on the fries themselves, and I was like, that's ghetto. Listen, I'm not gonna do that. It's probably even the way that they do it there. I don't know. I've never been to In-N-Out, but I'm gonna make the bechamel way. So I'm here making a bechamel sauce. I put a tablespoon of butter with a tablespoon of flour. I didn't put too much because I don't want it to be too thick. Like too thick cheese sauce grosses me out. This reminds me of middle school when we had the like really thick cheese sauce on the fries, which is disgusting. Okay, make sure you just put it on low. I had to cut some footage out because this is my second time. I'll be transparent. Because I had the heat too high, it just started cooking my flour too quickly. It literally smelled like, I don't even know what it smelled like in here. So just keep it on low and cook the flour, taste out of the flour for like 2 minutes. Add your milk and then add your seasonings. You're gonna wait for it to coat the spoon just like it did. And then you're gonna add your little cheese in there. I'm using this Vile Life cheddar cheese. It's probably the first time I've used this, to be honest. I don't really be buying a whole bunch of vegan cheese like that. So like shredded cheese, because I actually prefer like my tacos without cheese on them. Crazy, I know. So this is my first time using it. She's cool, you know what I'm saying? Probably, listen, I will always say this. I cape for Vile Life so hard because I think they're one of the best vegan cheeses out there. I also think they're among the most accessible. Probably more accessible would be like a Chao cheese. It's because like it's available at Walmart and Walmart's everywhere. But Vile Life is great. I will say this cheese is kind of mild, but like don't nobody need nothing punch them in their face, okay? So I melted my cheese in there, I seasoned it to taste, and bada boom, bada bing. It was so easy to do, period. Okay, so I'm just gonna saute some diced onion. It ain't nothing special here. Like, it's sauteing diced onion. But it's crazy because I'm always nervous to make a bechamel sauce because like I've always loved to cook, like even when I was like younger, like literally watching Ina Garten, taking notes, watching, you know, freaking Iron Chef, taking notes. And I was always scared of bechamel sauce because I never like really understood it. So I just have like a vague memory. It's not vague, I have a prominent memory of making a bechamel sauce and just putting the flour in and then just adding the milk right away. Lumps everywhere, tastes like flour, absolutely disgusting. So every time it comes out great, I'm like, this is not hard, every single time. Okay, I'm gonna go in, I'm gonna make the fry sauce, which is just Thousand Island dressing. I've made this before in my Big Mac video. Yeah, but I decided to refilm it because I changed it just a little bit. So I'm taking diced pickles, would not recommend. I put sweet relish in the actual recipe because I just prefer it. Mustard, ketchup, pepper, and a little bit of barbecue sauce. Not too much because barbecue sauce be loud, child. Like, relax, calm down. I ain't even all that. And I'm just adjusting it. Like, you see me like that, okay? And there it is, like really simple. I be making this on the low sometimes, like on a weekend or something when I wanna dip my fries. Okay, listen. I know it's supposed to be like the little thinner fries, but this is what I had. And I had all these ingredients in the house, which is very rare. Like, I normally always gotta run out real quick and get some for this channel. So I was like, I'm gonna use what I got. And I'm also very stubborn. I pulled up to Kroger today. I did. I pulled up to Kroger to get the fries and I got back in my car. I probably looked crazy because I had my Viola with me too. I had my instrument on my back. I'm going to the Kroger. I got right back in the car. I'm gonna use what I got. Okay, if I had waffle fries, okay, I probably wouldn't use waffle fries, but you're not filming it. Maybe you are, do what you want. I did what I want, you do what you want. So I just layered it, cheese sauce, Thousand Island, and my onions or whatever. Why did I make this clip so long, Jesus? Anyway, and there she is. Perfect, it was so good. Now I ain't gonna cap, I wouldn't make this every day because it's decadent. You know what I'm saying, it's Tuesday. You know what I'm saying, it's a lot for a Tuesday. But it was so, so good. Like I said, I've had it before and I kind of knew what to expect, but if you haven't had it, you have to try it. I hear people say that like In-N-Out is like overhyped. So let me know if you've been there before you went vegan, or you're not vegan, you just watching, hey. Let me know if you think it's overhyped. You know, I probably would never try it. So, but if you try this recipe, let me know if it lives up to what you had before. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. You know what? I'm gonna try to say that slower because I realize actually people be telling me I need to slow down. So here we go. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe so you never miss any of my videos. While you're here, check out my other videos. Why? Because I have enough video. I have enough of them. Like literally a lot of videos. Thank you again for watching and I will catch you in the next one. I'm out of breath. Like that's why I like to say so fast. Come on, say it fast, it's over. You see that? Like, it's over. I say it fast and it's over. Bada boom, bada bing. Bye, y'all.